Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1771, Count by Month. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question sent in via YouTube has dates, not just dates and time. Check this out. Hundreds of rows of this and needs to create a summary table that shows how many records per month. It says, I don't care about the time, don't care about what day of the month, just want to go back to the month. All right. It's not a Friday, it's not a Dueling Excel podcast, but I'm still going to be channeling Mike Excel is Fun Girvin here because I got this trick from his book. If we have to do this with a formula, we're going to have to use an if inside of an if. So the first thing we do, check to see if the month of all of these records over here, and I put dollar signs in using the F4 key, is equal to the month of this cell, D2. If that's true, then we start a brand new if statement. Now you're saying, wait a second, why don't we use the and function? Because Mike Girvin says we can't. Turns out if you're using an array function, and this is an array function, we're evaluating a lot of rows in each function, and does not work. I also tried EO month, thinking that would ease it. But no, with array functions, you're not allowed to do that. So first thing we do, check to see if the month of all of those is equal to the month of this. And then if that's true, see if the year of all of those cells is equal to the year of D2. If that's true, put a 1, otherwise 0, otherwise 0. All right, so that returns, in this case, it looks like 374 different results, either 1s or 0s. So we need to wrap those in another function, equal sum. We'll do it. So it'll add up all the 1s and 0s. Now, can we just press Enter here? You see it doesn't work. You have to hold down Control and Shift and press Enter to make that into an array formula. Double-click to shoot it down, and you're good to go. That's a confusing formula. It'd be much easier. You know, I'm guessing this data is not really going to change. It's not like someone's going to come in here and say, oh, no, this really happened at February 5th. Boy, it'd be so much easier if we could just create a pivot table. 9 mouse clicks, in fact. So let's do that. Choose one cell in the data, insert, pivot table, OK. And we're going to put date down the left-hand side. We're also going to put date in the value area, and Excel is going to be smart enough to know that we want to count that. And then choose the very first date cell. Very important we do that. Under options, we're going to choose group field and choose months and years. Click OK, and we're done. Now for each year, we get to see by month how many records there were. If you want to see a total by year, well, that's kind of a weird bug there. I've talked about this before. Go into options, field settings, and turn the subtotals to automatic to get the yearly totals to appear as well. Okay, so your choice, either a array formula from the book Control+Shift+Enter or a pivot table. The array formula will update. If something here would change, then it will automatically update, and I guess that's a good thing. But if your data is not going to change, boy, 9 clicks to create a pivot table seems to be the way to go. Oh, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. So, hey, there's a lot of ways to connect with us here at Mr. Excel. If you're looking for an Excel book, DVD, ebook, something for your Kindle, for your iPad, go to MrExcel.com/store. Lots of different choices. Books written by me, books written by other MVPs. Lots of good Excel resources out there.